is ever so necessary for giving us wisdom. Father, help us to feast on your word today, that we will be wiser. We thank you, Abba Father. Let your word be a lamp unto our feet, a light unto our path. Let it illuminate us. We bless your name. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Today, the Lord wants to take us to the zoo. We are going on an excursion to the zoo. And when you go to the zoo, you meet all kinds of animals.
Amen.
And these animals have all kinds of characters.
Yes.
Amen.
And the Lord wants to take us to the zoo today. You see, in Genesis chapter 2, God says it is not good for man to be alone. So the next thing God does is he starts to make animals for man. And he makes all kinds of animals for man. And says, Adam, start to give them names. So Adam starts to give all the animals their names. Till today, even when new living beings are discovered, it's man that gives them names. A new bacteria, a new virus, whatever is discovered, it is man that gives it the name. So Adam begins to name the animals. God says, yet none of these animals are suitable to be his companion. So I'm going to have to put him in deep sleep. You see, when God created the other animals, the Bible says he did that from the dust of the earth. He didn't have to put Adam to sleep. Adam did not have to go to bed for God to create the other animals. But God said none of these are suitable for him. He cannot have companionship with any of these. Today we have some Adams that are into bestiality. God says, no, that is not what I have for you. And so he puts Adam to sleep. And from Adam comes the woman. And Adam gives the woman her name. Says woman, because she was taken out of man. And then as we transition further in the scripture, we are introduced to the first animal, the serpent. So the first animal we see besides man is the serpent. And the Bible says the serpent was more crafty than any other animal the Lord made. So the first introduction we get to the animal kingdom is the serpent. And is the craftiest of all. So when the devil wanted to make man fall, Satan is smart. He said, I won't look for a foolish animal. This work I have to do, this assignment I have to do to bring man down, I will look at the resume of all the animals. And it is the smartest one I will use against man. There was lion, there was tiger. As strong as they are, they were not as crafty as the serpent. So the first animal we come across is the cunning serpent. And the devil used him to orchestrate the downfall of man. Why are we going to the zoo today? Why are we going to the animal kingdom? Because every animal has its character. And when you see an animal in your dream, it is depicting a certain character that is going on in your life or a certain event. When you see yourself and you're surrounded by serpents, you need to pray because a fall is imminent. The serpent is the staff of the devil's office. A fall is imminent. When you see yourself surrounded by serpents, and then in Luke chapter 10 verse 19, Jesus tells us, I have given you authority over the serpent. Don't let that serpent command you. You command the serpent in my name. I've given you authority to trample on the serpent and on the scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. Nothing shall by any means hurt you. As crafty as the serpent is, it contains poison. There are some serpents that have very quick poison. And there are some serpents that have very slow poison. You'll be dying slowly. But the thing the serpent knows is that as soon as it injects the venom, it knows its victim is on the way to death. And it will just be watching. It doesn't even have to begin to swallow at once. As soon as he injects the poison, he knows death is imminent. And that's what happened in the Garden of Eden. The serpent spoke, and he spoke poison into Adam and Eve. He spoke deception to Adam and Eve. And as soon as they swallowed the deception, the poison, they died. Because God said, the day you shall eat of the tree of knowledge of good and evil, you shall surely die. And that was the day man died. Man was separated from God. And it took the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ to reconcile us back to the Father. But now, we need not be scared of the serpent, because we have the authority. He's under our feet. Amen? Amen. We've been given authority over serpents and scorpions. Serpents bite. Scorpions sting. So that is the first animal we see. Let us continue. There are other animals the Bible makes reference to. We see the leopard. The leopard is in the cat's family. Let us go to Jeremiah 13, verse 23. Jeremiah chapter 13, verse 23. I thought I had a King James Bible here. It's okay. Jeremiah 13, verse 23. I read. Can the Ethiopian change his skin, or the leopard his spots? Then may ye also do good that are accustomed to do evil. What the Bible is saying is that it is impossible for the leopard to change his skin. It's false. So when you're presented with a situation and you see the spirit of the leopard, that means there is no repentance. He cannot change his faults. The way that person is the way it's going to be. Son of perdition. Son of perdition cannot repent. He's just what he is. The leopard cannot change his spots. Even when you bring blood of Jesus to wash the leopard, he still wants to remain a leopard. The leopard is different from the lion. The leopard cannot change his spots. But the lion is different in the Bible. We're talking spirit now. The lion can be on your side and it can be against you. Leopard is never on your side. There is the lion of the tribe of Judah. Amen. When you dream, I've had a dream. I write down my dreams. I've had a dream where I was sitting on a table with guests. And someone told me to get up from the table, that my meal is not here. And a lion brought my plates to me. And served me in the dream.
Amen.
And served me in the dream. I said, this is not the roaring lion. Amen. This is the lion of the tribe of Judah.
Amen.
Then there's a roaring lion. Satan. So when you have that kind of dream with lion, you must know what the lion is doing. Don't just say, oh, I saw a lion in the dream. What was that lion doing? Now the lion is not to be the king of the jungle. When other animals see the lion, they give way. They give way to the lion. And meanwhile, the lion is a very inactive animal. One of the laziest animals. He likes to sleep. He can sleep all day, but he's a king. If you wake it up from his sleep, you will know who he is. They say, let sleeping dogs lie. Let sleeping lions lie. Now, when you see a lion pursuing you in the dream, must know the character of that lion and what you are doing. Because God might as well be pursuing you because there's a call for you. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying?
Yes, amen.
So you must begin to understand the animals because they have different characters in the spirit realm. There is the dog family. In the dog family, you have dog, you have wolf, you have fox, you have jackal, you have coyote. There are so many of them in the dog family. But one thing we know, in the dog family, the wolf, let's look at the spirit of the wolf. You've had wolf among sheep. Wolf among sheep in the Bible. So when the wolf we get, remember it's in the dog family, and we use dog for security. Who knows that? Dog is an animal we use for security. So the wolf is in that family, so he wants to pass as a dog. He looks like a dog, but it's a wolf. And the sheep will see the wolf and think they are secure. They say, it's okay, we are safe. But that is the wolf that will slaughter all the sheep in the pen. And sometimes you will have a revelation. God will say, be careful, that is a wolf.
Ooh.
You think that is a sheep, it's a wolf. It's coming to devour. Be careful.
Yes.
Be discerning because that is a wolf.
Yes.
And when God says that is a wolf, it behooves you to understand the character of the wolf.
Amen.
What does that mean?
Amen.
That is a wolf. That is a devourer.
Yes.
In the book of Acts, Acts chapter 20, Paul warns the church. Let us go to Acts chapter 20, verse 29. Is somebody following today?
Amen.
Amen.
Today is not a sermon, today is an expose.
Amen.
Acts chapter 20, verse 29. Paul is talking. For I know this, that after my departing, shall grievous wolves enter in among you, not sparing the flock. Acts 20, verse 29. Not sparing the flock. Wolves don't spare the flock. They want to take everything from the flock. In quotes, man of God in quotes, pastor can be a wolf. He can be a wolf. He will just be taking everything from the flock. And the wolf is growing fat at the flock. They are growing thin. Because he's a wolf among the sheep. He doesn't care for the sheep. There's a good shepherd that cares for the sheep, but the wolf doesn't care for the sheep. The wolf just wants to suck all the blood that the sheep have. It's a wolf. And some of us are not discerning. We will see ourselves working with a dog, and we think it's a dog, but it might be a wolf.
Amen.
The wolf is one of the most dangerous in the dog family. But more cunning than the wolf in the dog family is the fox. As sly as a fox. They say the dog is man's best friend. The fox is the friend in the dog family that will stab you in the back.
Yes.
The Bible says in Song of Solomon, it is the little foxes that spoil the vine. You think they are harmless, but they are the ones that spoil the vine. And when you see foxes in your dream, that means be careful. You need to put a hedge around something. You need to safeguard something. Because when you see foxes converging, it's to destroy your vine. It's to destroy your blessing. What did Samson do? He put foxes together, bind them by the tail, and let them loose. And they destroyed the farmland of the Philistines. Any fox in your life, that fox, die in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I'm talking to the spirit, to the fox.
Amen.
It will die.
Amen.
Because if you don't kill that thing will destroy your blessing. And when the devil wants to do it, he will send the fox into a human being. And now, you will have a relationship with that human being. But you don't know that inside that human being is a fox. We've done deliverance here, maybe 2, 1, 3, 6 months. And the person will be barking like a dog. We've done deliverance here, and the person will be like, oh, 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 we'll say, what's going on? Because that spirit is inside the person. So you see the wolf and the fox. Then there's the dog proper. The dog. Dog is ready to have sex anyway.
Amen.
Very loose animal. That's why you hear the expression, just sleeping around like a dog.
Right.
They have that spirit in them. And that spirit has to be cast out. That spirit has to be cast out. Dog is very indiscriminate. Ready to do what it has to do anywhere. You must understand the character of the animals. God says in Psalm 50, He says all the animals in the forest are mine. That means He knows each and every one of them and what they are capable of. He says all the animals in the forest are mine. I own the cattle on the thousand hill. When you see cattle in your dream, that is blessing. That is property. And you have to ask God for wisdom. For wisdom to multiply your cattle. God gave that wisdom to Jacob. And Laban was so upset because by the time they looked at the spotted cattle, Jacob had everything. The Bible also tells us about the sheep and goats. He said, on the last day, I will separate the sheep from the goats. The goats look like sheep, but they're not sheep. They talk sometimes like sheep, but they're not sheep. They act like they're sheep, but they're not sheep. Maybe you've had a dream. And there's somebody you admire, the person can quote scripture, he can pray. And then you see that person in the dream. And you're having a conversation with the person, and the person makes my hair. The goat. Just pretending to be a sheep. The Lord is revealing something to you.
Amen.
Seriously.
Amen.
God looked like sheep, but not sheep. He says, then there's the lamb. Hallelujah.
Yes.
There is the lamb. He said, I'm sending you as lamb among wolves. But because you're a lamb, be wise as a serpent, the first animal you meet in the Bible. He said, lamb, go and get wisdom from the serpent. Don't take his character. Don't take his character, but be wise as he is. We always give this example. If a snake comes in here, hardly would you notice it. It will go and hide behind that, whatever that thing is at the back. It will hide there. When everybody leaves, it will come out. It will survey the environment. Then it will go back and hide there. And wait for the day that only one person will be in the sanctuary. Then it will strike. Don't you see that when the serpent struck, you waited for only one person, Eve. Adam was not there. Then it struck. So he said, I'm sending you as lamb among wolves, but be wise as a serpent, and gentle as a dove. The next animal you see is the dove. Let's talk about the dove. It says gentle as the dove. When John the Baptist came to baptize in the River Jordan, they told him that the Messiah is the one that you will see the Holy Spirit descend upon as a dove. Not so. John chapter 1. And as he was baptizing in the Jordan, there comes Jesus, the Lamb of God. And John the Baptist says, behold the Lamb of God that taketh away the sins of the world. So Jesus is depicted as a lamb. So the lamb comes before John the Baptist, and the dove descends upon the lamb. The dove locates the lamb. the dove will not descend on the goat. It will not descend on the goat. It will descend on the lamb. Because the lamb and the dove, they have the same character. They are gentle. Goat is very stubborn. Americans may not know a goat, but if you're an African person here, you know the goat. We keep them in our yards. They are very stubborn animals. You put them in one place, they go all over the place to mess up the place. Sheep will be where you get it. So the dove descended upon the lamb. That is a gentle bird. There are other birds the Bible talks about. Wicked birds, evil birds, the owl. Satan likes that owl just like he likes the snake. Then there is the bird, and this bird, the Bible calls this bird a very foolish bird. Because this bird is an expert at child abuse, child neglect. And when you see child abuse, child neglect in our society, that person that is doing that thing, that mother that is doing that, has the spirit of the ostrich. Because the ostrich is the bird that will lay its egg and forget about it and go about doing his business. And you see that today in our society. In our society. Because those are foolish people. They don't know that that is their future investment. Because they want to look after them in their old age. They are thinking that Social Security will look after them in their old age. Not knowing that the Social Security fund will be exhausted. Instead of investing in their children, they invest in nonsense. That is the ostrich. Then there's the peacock. As proud as a peacock. The peacock is the bird that wants every other bird to see its feathers. If you go to the zoo and you see the peacock, you say, see all my feathers. They are beautiful. And they are beautiful. And to take his head off. And then to show you. That's what the peacock does. The peacock, that spirit, it's like the Leviathan spirit. Pride. Pride. It wants everybody to know its accomplishments. Who cares if you have a PhD? Just serve Jesus. Peacock. Oh, I'm offended. You didn't call me apostle, doctor, prophet. Dare you call me Brother ID? Don't you know who I am?
Amen.
Sorry, who are you? Peacock. That's what you are, peacock. That's the Leviathan spirit, spirit of pride. We'll come to Leviathan. The parents are very significant. We did a deliverance in Maryland, the Brother Case Church. And the lady from Atlanta that came to Maryland, she said a bird followed her. She drove. Aha. A bird followed her all the way from Atlanta to Maryland. When she would stop to buy gas, the bird would stop. When she would stop at the restaurant, the bird would stop. You say, well, that bird is not following you back to Atlanta. Because the enemy put a spirit in that bird. People are not descending. Just like a spirit entered the serpent. The enemy put a spirit in that bird that was monitoring her. You will find out that that bird can fly faster than the usual bird of its kind. If a funny bird comes by your window, just say whatever may be in you, I bind it in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
And that bird followed her. Now, there are still other birds. There's the eagle. Everybody say class.
Class.
You shall mount up with wings as an eagle. When you see an eagle in your dream, God is either telling you it's time for you to rise up.
Yes.
That, hey, why are you like the chicken?
Amen.
Don't you know you're like an eagle?
Amen.
That you're supposed to mount up with wings as an eagle. The eagle is a leader. When you hear, they say, oh, we're having a conference, the gathering of eagles, the gathering of leaders. The eagle knows what it wants and it goes for it. It doesn't have committee meetings. It doesn't even consult other brands and say, you know what, I think I should do this today. No, the eagle already knows what it wants and it goes for it. It's a leader. And the ego knows how to train other leaders. The eagle is the one that when he wants to teach his bird to fly, his baby, he will drop him in the sky. The baby will be shouting and he will catch him. He will do it again. On up, say, it's time for you to leave the nest.
Amen.
If you see yourself as an eaglet, God is saying it's time for you to grow up. Amen. Become an eagle.
Amen.
So we're going through the zoo. Because God made all the animals.
Yes.
And all the animals have their characters. And we need to understand that these animals we are mentioning, they're in the Bible. Isaiah 40, 31. You will mount up with the wind as an eagle. And then it continues. It says, you will run and not be weary. You will walk and not faint. Where are we? Then there's the pigeon. As peaceful as it is, it's a very expendable bird. Very expendable. In the Old Testament, if you couldn't afford to kill a lamb as a sacrifice, don't say, okay, you're very poor, go and buy a pigeon. Very expendable bird. So when you see yourself holding pigeon, you're holding on to something that cannot endure. You're holding on to something that cannot endure. It is expendable. Don't hold on tightly to that kind of thing. I remember the house I grew up in Lagos, Nigeria. Lots of pigeons would come. In the time I grew up in Nigeria, in the early 70s, Nigeria was just developing as an oil economy. So it was still very green. Very green. Even by the gutters, you see fish, you see all kinds of things. Alligators. And pigeons will come. They are very common. If you are to catch a pigeon and put it in a cage, all your friends will laugh at you. They will say, this is ridiculous. How can you keep a pigeon in a cage? I mean, we are catching parrots. We are catching canaries. We are catching, you know, wonderful birds. The pigeon is just a simple bird. It might not be very common here, but it's just a simple bird you see everywhere. It's very common. You're not created to be common. You're created to be an eagle. Like an eagle. Let's move on. The Bible in Deuteronomy 22 verse 10. It says, do not plow your field with an ox and an ass on the same yoke. The ox is a very strong animal. He likes to walk. Very hard-working animal. The ass just likes to lay around, play, and sit on his butt and do nothing. So when you see yourself in a dream, and you're holding an ass, and you're walking with the ass, God is saying, don't marry that person. Don't marry that person. Why are you getting too attached to this ass? Drop him or drop her. It's an ass. As we just frustrate you, frustrate the ox. When an ox marries an ass, before you know it, the ox will start to behave like an ass. The ass will never behave like an ox. Forget it. It's not ready for that. It's the ox that will behave like the ass. Because the ox will become frustrated and say, what's the point? It's good to know your animals because God gave you the responsibility to give them their names. They are subject to you. But if you don't know your animals, how sad will it be that God that gave dominion to man over animals, if your animals start to rule you and have dominion over you? Why should a serpent be telling a human being what to do?
Amen.
It's the other way around. An animal we don't see this I have not seen it. It's the dragon. He talks about this animal that can bring fire out of his mouth. He says it's a dragon. You won't see a dragon on earth, but you can see it in your dream. If you see it in your dream, that tells you you're in the spirit. The Bible tells us of creatures that have eyes all over their body. Have you seen any creature like that here? But you can see that in your dream. Because in the world of your dream, in the spirit realm, you're open to anything. So there's the dragon associated with Satan. And in Revelation chapter 12, we see the lamb defeat the dragon. When the Bible talks about the great dragon, it talks about the dragon in the same sentence, Revelation chapter 12, with the ancient serpent. And then it says, that goes to deceive the whole world. He doesn't deceive the whole world in his capacity as dragon. He deceives the whole world in his capacity as serpent. Are we following?
Yeah.
When you see somebody, let me break down that dragon spirit for you, because I know it's a bit out. It's a very incendiary spirit. When you see somebody go in anger from 0 to 100 in 1 second, that's the dragon. There's some people, you're having a pleasant conversation, and you just say, you know what? I'm voting for the Tea Party. How do you vote for the Tea Party? That's the dragon. From 0 to 100, you just explode. So when you're praying for that person, you say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I bind that dragon spirit in brother X. I forbid that dragon spirit from manifesting in sister Y. When you begin to understand the characteristics of these animals, you know how to pray for people. Because we see what they are manifesting. We've done deliverance here, and you see the person swimming back. You see the person on the floor swimming. Not so. Because that person has a water spirit. A spirit that dwelleth in the rivers. That's why you see them swimming here like they are in the ocean. Because that spirit must assume its character. Must manifest its character. You also have this, the pig. Everybody say, you.
Yeah.
No matter how you clean up a pig, it will be clean, so long as there's no mud.
Right.
But the moment it sees mud, forget it. Let us turn to Matthew chapter 7. Praise the Lord, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Are we getting something from this?
Yes.
Matthew chapter 7. I read verse 6. Give not that which is holy unto the dogs. Neither cast ye your pearls before swine, pigs, lest they trample them under their feet and turn again and rend you. The Bible says, don't cast your pearl before swine. Your pearl are things that are valuable. Now, let me tell you the things that are valuable in the sight of God. When God says your pearl, your feet. Don't take your faith to a place where swine are that they will be ridiculing your God. Don't go to a place where they will say, oh, you believe in that Jesus? That is swine.
Yeah.
Leave them alone. Jesus did not die for everybody. He died for whosoever will believe in him. Matthew 20, 28 says, even as the Son of God came not to minister, but to minister and to give his life as a ransom for many. Not for all, for many. Go and read it.
Amen.
Don't cast your pearl before swine. Your pearl are for people that need that faith to believe in the Master.
Amen.
Have you ever gone to preach to somebody and when you left, you felt like, oh boy, why did I even do that? And you're just like, damn. You bring to some people and you're up, you're like, thank you, Jesus, I sow the seed. Lord, work in that seed. And then you bring to some other people, you're like, oh boy. It's like you got a business. That's fine. I once had a dream. And in that dream, I saw a pig vomiting gold coins. I said, wow, this is interesting, my dream. And when I woke up, I said, God, what does that mean? And he said, my son, all that glitters is not gold. The source of that gold is from Satan. And there is a gold, once upon a time in my life, that Satan promised me. And God was showing me in that dream that I was going to receive gold from Satan. Don't cast your pearl before swine. The devil likes swine because swine is filth. It's associated with filth. The legion of demons, what did they say? They say, cast us into the swine. Lord, bid us live into the swine. And one thing about pig is that they are one of the animals that multiply very rapidly. It's easy to breed pigs. They multiply very rapidly. They can give birth to like 14, 15 children, piglets. When you see pig like that, it means evil is increasing. Be careful. Let's move on in this room. Now you have the rat's family. Rat and mouse. That's the spirit of the devourer. Period. Devouring spirit. When you see that in the dream, it's either one thing. The devil, be careful, the devil is coming to steal for you. Or they want to use you as guinea pig experiments. That is not your portion and my portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Are we following?
Yes.
If you have a mouse in your house, you will look for a trap to catch it. Don't let the mouse or the rat run loose all around you, because it's a devourer. When you want to go and eat your loaf of bread, you will see a big hole in the middle.
Amen.
You think the bread is still whole, but when you carry it up, it will be very light. Now, what happened? So there, when you look at the rat, that is an animal you want to keep out of your house. Right? So to keep it out of your house, you must have an appropriate hedge. You must make sure that all the holes are sealed. If they are not sealed, it will enter. The Bible says in Genesis, sin is crouching at your door. You must master it. That is like a mouse. It crouches at the door. As soon as you open it, it's gone in. To get it out is a problem. Let us look at the chameleon. Chameleon spirit. Chameleon spirit is the spirit that can easily adapt to its environment. When it's in the church, you behave like a Christian. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory. When it's in the nightclub, he's dead.
Yes. Tell it.
That's chameleon spirit.
Teach.
It will assume the color of its environment. And as Christians, we must be careful, because the Bible says in the book of Romans chapter 12 that we should not conform to the pattern of this world. And the chameleon is very adept, very skilled at conforming to the pattern of this world. And when it enters the church, it wears a robe of righteousness. Fake righteousness. Christian on Sunday, something else on Monday. A wonderful classmate of mine in Nigeria. When he came to visit me, maybe like 5 years ago in the US, he was a Muslim. My old classmates, we grew up together. And he was staying in a hotel. He came for some conference in New York. I said, how dare you stay in a hotel? Come and stay with me. So he came to stay with me. He started to talk about Jesus. He said, he's a Christian now. He's a Christian now. He said, yeah, look at Jesus. My wife is a Christian, but I'm a Muslim. See what I was saying? He said, when I want to pray, I go to the mosque. When I want to dance, because I'm happy, I did a contract and they gave me money. I want to dance. I go to my wife's church. But I'm a Muslim. That was an indictment as far as I was concerned to the church. Because Allah is telling me that that church did not have the anointing to rescue him. Then the following, 2 years after I wrote on Facebook, I've given my life to the Lord. I say amen.
Amen.
And they say I have to change my name because they are looking to kill me. It's in northern Nigeria. They put death threat on me. So back to what we are saying. Don't let your environment define you. You define your environment. If your environment defines you, then you are a chameleon. We don't know the real you. You know what it is to say, you know what? This sister is so nice. Oh, we just lost Sister Mary. I hope there's no Mary here. We just lost Sister Mary. Sister Mary is so nice. Everybody at this that Sister Mary is so nice. But we've not seen her in church for like 3 weeks. So we send somebody to her apartment. We get to her place. We say, please, we are looking for Mary. That troublemaker! You mean Mary? Which Mary?
Yeah.
Mary that fights everybody in this apartment complex.
Yes, yes, yes.
Mary? You say yes!
Wow.
Chameleon. That is the spirit that Jesus dealt with a lot. That spirit was in the Pharisees. It's a very subtle religious spirit. Assume self-righteousness. Then there's the crown. Let us turn in our Bibles to 1 Corinthians chapter 1. We'll learn something about the crown in 1 Corinthians chapter 1. Are you there? Verse 10. Now I beseech you, brethren, by the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that ye all speak the same thing, and that there be no divisions among you, but that ye be perfectly joined together in the same mind and in the same judgment. What that scripture is saying is that you all be in agreement. Let us all be in agreement. Now the spirit of the crowd is in agreement with you so long as both of you are at the bottom.
Yes.
But once you want to go to the top,
oh, yes,
the spirit of the crab will not agree with you. The crab spirit only agrees with you when you are at the bottom.
Yes.
But as soon as you want to climb up, the crab will throw you down. That's what crab put the crab in a bucket. The one that wants to go up, the others will pull him down. They say, no, you ain't going up without me. Come down. We are all going to be at the bottom. When your place of employment and you're about to get a promotion, I say, guess what? They called me in for a raise. Your co-worker will be like, and I got here before her. And I do more work than her. That is the crab. Then that person will go behind your back to the boss. They say, oh, I hear you're about to give Sister Mary a raise. Sister Mary, that leaves work before time. I will say she left at the right time. Sister Mary that comes to work late.
See?
I will say she came at 9.
Tell it.
That's what you want. That is a crab talking against Sister Mary.
See?
That is a crab talking against Sister Mary. Want to pull her down. God says all the animals are his. He knows how he created them. He knows what they are capable of. He knows what they will. That is a crab. We are doing one deliverance conference here, and we saw the spirit of crab in somebody's family. Who remembers that? The person was trying to rise up, but it was members of her own household that were pulling her down. When it's time for her to be elevated, they will use witchcraft spirit to pull her down. She will never rise up. Crab spirits. There's the elephant. You don't really see elephant in the Bible, but there's the elephant. In the morning service, somebody said, "Pastor, I forgive you, but I can never forget." That's elephant. The elephant, 25 years can come back, the elephant will remember.
Yes.
That's the elephant. You can never forget. They did so much damage to Joseph, his brothers. And God took him to the land of Egypt. And he named his son Ephraim. He said, "The Lord has made me fruitful." And he named the other son Manasseh. "The Lord has made me to forget."
Amen.
When you forget, that means the sting has been removed. You still see the scar? The scar is there as a reminder. But you forget because the sting is no more there. When you think about the matter, you say, "Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus." Don't be like the elephant. When an animal has the elephant, if the elephant sees that animal 20 years time and has the opportunity to do this, you think the elephant is crazy? He remembers what happened 20 years ago. You just be doing this to the other animal. Even the other animal would have forgotten. Talk to your neighbor, say neighbor.
Neighbor.
Forgive and forget.
Yes.
You have the fish. Remember, Jesus grew up by the waters.
Amen.
Jesus grew up in marine territory. The man from Galilee, by the Sea of Galilee.
Fish.
Most of his disciples were fishers of men. They were fishers. The fish is a very interesting animal. The fish is like a prison. When Jonah was misbehaving, God prepared a prison facility for him. Put him inside there. That was God's prison for him. God prepared that prison for him, a big fish. Satan also has fish that he uses in the water. When it was time for Jesus and his disciples to pay their tax, the disciples started to panic. That, "Master, we don't even have money to pay the tax." He said, "Go to the water. The first fish you can find, you will find gold coin inside the fish. Bring it and use it to pay my tax and your tax." What is money doing inside the mouth of a fish? Have you ever asked yourself that question? That money belonged to Jesus and his disciples, but it was inside Marine Kingdom. Jesus will not take money that doesn't belong to him. He's not Judas. His disciples will not take money that does not belong to them. That was their money, but it was inside the marine kingdom, inside the mouth of the fish. So go and catch that fish. Every marine power that has swallowed your blessing, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord will make them vomit it out.
Yes.
I said they will vomit it out.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
They will not be able to keep your good virtues in their kingdom.
Yes.
Some of you will have dreams, you see yourself swimming in the water. Be careful, that little fish might be a shark. Might be a shark. Just waiting to pull you down. Just waiting to pull you down. In the zoo, there's a special section called the aquarium. Marine Kingdom. And the boss, just like you said, the boss of the jungle is the lion. The boss of Marine Kingdom is the spirit called Leviathan. The Leviathan spirit. You come across him in Isaiah 27 and in the book of Job very briefly. Let us look at him briefly and then we close. Isaiah 27 verse 1. I've not lost anybody.
Oh.
Isaiah 27, verse 1. in that day, the Lord with his sword and great and strong sword. Everybody say sword.
Sword.
That's the word of God. The word of God, the issue judgment. Shall punish Leviathan, the piercing serpent. Even Leviathan, that crooked serpent. And he shall slay the dragon that is in the sea. What is the dragon doing inside the sea? It's a spirit. Let us go to Job chapter 41. That is where we really catch this spirit. Some have said it's the crocodile. Some have said it's something else. But whatever it is, we shall understand this character as we close. Job chapter 41, dealing with the Leviathan spirit. Canst thou draw out Leviathan with a hook, or his tongue with a cord which thou lettest down? Can thou put a hook into his nose, or bore his jaw through with a thorn? Will he, Leviathan, make any supplications unto thee? Will he speak soft words unto thee? Will he make a covenant with thee? Will thou take him for a servant forever? Will thou play with him as with a bird? Or will thou bind him for thy maidens? Shall the companions make a banquet of him? Shall they part him among the merchants? Canst thou fill his skin with barbed irons, or his head with fish spears? Lay thy hand upon him. Remember the battle, do no more. Let me tell you what the Bible is saying there. The Bible says the day you lay your hand on Leviathan, you will never lay your hand on him again. You will remember that battle. You will remember that battle. We dealt with the spirit of Leviathan here, like maybe May last year. That was the day I told everybody to empty out the sanctuary. This man came from Long Island. We emptied out the sanctuary. Thank God I had big, big brothers with me that day. I had Brother Andre, big, big brothers with me. Brother Anthony, remember Anthony?
Yeah.
When that Leviathan spirit manifested, short guy, you're like, oh boy. Even me, God forgive me, I was like, Papa will come next Sunday. Because we are worn out. He wore us out. It's a battle we will remember. And some of us are dealing with that kind of power. And you cannot fight that power without fasting and prayer. Because that kind, only goeth out by fasting and prayer. It's not the one you just say, come out in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We had a lady from Barbados, maybe like 2-3 years ago, that came to our meeting. Brother K sent her to us. We said, Holy Ghost fire! And the spirit in her laughed. He said, fire, I will show you who the God of fire is. My name is Shango. I will show you what fire is. When that demon began to show us fire, we had to be returning fire for fire, for fire, for fire, for fire. The battle continued in Maryland in Brother K's church. We had to use a bed sheet, a curtain, to tie the woman to the chair. At the end of the day, we didn't get that demon out. We did not. Who knows what legal right that demon has, but we didn't get that demon out. But like that demon said, today you will know you met fire. And in all honesty, that day we met fire. Because that is like Leviathan. But it can be destroyed.
Amen.
It can be destroyed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
But if you accommodate that spirit, and then you bring 20 people to cast out that demon, what can they do? You must disagree with your Leviathan. Leviathan is the king of pride. God resists the proud. I've given you very many animals today. I once had a dream. I write down my dreams. And in that dream, I went to a brother's house. This was a time when I was going through homelessness. And I went to a brother's house. And as I entered the house, there were monkeys all over the place. I said, this is strange. In the dream, I said, why are there so many monkeys all over the place? They were just turning the house upside down. The monkey is a very mysterious animal. Spirit of mischief. They were just turning the house upside down. And then all of a sudden in the dream, a gorilla came. And as soon as the gorilla came, all the monkeys just bowed down to the gorilla. I said, this is Satan. This is Satan. They all bowed down to the gorilla. They just stopped. Then they continued doing what they were doing. Because their boss had entered in the dream. When you see monkeys all over the place, that is confusion and mischief. If you have the opportunity, Google BBC, Kenyan villagers' monkeys, and see what monkeys did to the Kenyan villagers. In the Western world, you think these animals are cute. But in the countries that have these animals, they don't really care for these animals because these animals are not as cute as we think. Talk to your neighbor, say neighbor.
Neighbor.
Don't be offended.
Don't be offended.
But which kind of animal do you resemble? Lamb or wolf?
Lamb or wolf.
I'm thinking you're a lamb.
Are you a lamb?
Are you a lamb?
Or are you something else?
Father, we just thank you today. Father, for this expose. Father, we thank you that you gave man the responsibility to name the animals. We thank you that it wasn't the animals that gave man his name. Lord, we bless you and you've given us dominion over these things. Lord, you've given us dominion and authority over snakes and scorpions, and over all the power of the enemy. In whatever shape the devil will come, in whatever guise Satan will come, Lord, you've given us dominion over him. Lord, we thank you that we are seated in the high places with Christ Jesus, far above principalities and powers. Lord, we thank you that even all the animals in the forest that are yours are subject to us in your name. Lord, we give you glory. In any way, oh God, anyone here has surrendered or compromised their authority to any spirit. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the name that you honor, in the name above every other name, Lord, I ask in the name of Jesus that they recover back that authority.
Amen.
That they recover back that authority. In whatever way it has been compromised, that authority will be restored. I thank you, Father, that we are more than conquerors. We are overcomers in Christ. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.